the meat, poultry, and fish slaughter industry will make these glossy commercials for Blue Buffalo with Blue Buffalo and Purina and Kibbles and Bits. But these are lies. What's really going on is that the poor, sick animals that are terrorized and can't be used for human consumption wind up in all pet-grade meat-based foods. So the ones that can't be used for human consumption because they're too sick become pet food. They're ground up in the pet food grinding plants, and they're ground up alive. They are terrorized. They cry for their lives while they're being forced into the grinders. It's horrible. It's horrible. And all that can be prevented just by switching to a vegan diet for your dogs and cats and ferrets. There's no, absolutely no reason to use meat-based pet foods for dogs, cats, and ferrets, except for the fact that people are brainwashed. They believe these misrepresentative commercials by the meat, poultry, and fish slaughter industry. People don't realize that they're eating, that their pets are eating the flesh, blood, and sewage of sick animals in all pet-grade meat-based foods. So we hope you'll buy vegan. I hope you'll buy evolution pet foods, because that's, those are the ones we manufacture, but there are others. Ami is another good one. There's V-Dog. Don't buy from meat production companies, because meat production companies are only manufacturing vegan pet foods to put vegan pet food companies out of business. All the other products they're making are from tortured, terrorized, and butchered alive sick animals. So don't support them in any way. You know, always buy from vegan companies. We hope you'll do that.
And the pet foods. I had a conversation with a woman today who called herself a vegan, and then she said, "Oh, I think I talked to you before." She said, "You're the one with the cats and dogs who are vegan." And I said, "Well, yes, I'm not going to torture animals and have pets, my pets eating tortured animals and call myself a vegan." And she was offended because I said, "You know, if you're going to be feeding tortured animals to your pets, even though you are not eating them yourself, you are not, you're a plant-based person for yourself, but you are not a vegan." Veganism connotes compassion, and that's not compassion. I don't know if Eric is still on the line, but Eric has become a steady rock in this World Peace Diet study group, and he formulated a pet food company over 25 years ago, and I have cats and dogs, 5 cats and 2 dogs. All the cats were throwaways and the dogs were giveaways, but all the cats were throwaways and they've been rescued, and they've been on Eric's pet food now go almost 8 years, and they're in beautiful condition. They're in beautiful shape. And
Of course, it's
evolution diet. Are you still on the line, Eric? He might not be, because usually if he is, he'll come right on.
Right. I just posted recently on a Facebook group. He was asking for people to actually write reviews there. I actually gave him a 5 star out of 5, because I find that a lot of people, even vegans, a lot of my friends, believe it or not, ethical vegans that have been vegan for like years, don't feed their companion animals vegan food. They might
say, "Well, they're not vegans," and that's what I'm trying to tell you, Michael. They're plant-based people.
Of course,
vegan. You know, they are not vegan at all. They're eating a plant-based diet, and that's the end of it. They're not really a vegan. To call yourself, as soon as I became vegan, as soon as my eyes were opened, I immediately looked for a pet food company, and if I could not have found one, I would have found a way to make make the foods for my pets myself. And, you know, the oldest dog that ever lived was a vegan dog, 28 years. Yeah. And you can look it up. I'm not making this up. So, I don't consider anyone who's feeding their pets meat-based products with tortured animals and, as Eric likes to say, diseased, horrible animals. They're not vegan. Yeah. They're just using a plant-based diet for themselves. It is not ethical.
Of course.
The pet food companies are totally unethical. They're totally unethical.
And what people don't realize as well is not only are these conventional pet foods, they contain all the farmed animals. They contain diseased animals that are unfit for human consumption. Another thing also is that where do dogs, cats, and all these other animals from laboratories end up? A lot of them end up in conventional pet foods. And that is why I and others like me recommend any brand like Amy, D-Dog, or Eric's brand, Evolution Diet. And it's so important because we are still contributing to the torture, to the violence, to the killing of these animals. And I mean, there's literally a lot of us have companion animals, and the only way to do it is, to just stop feeding them like conventional pet foods. And a lot of people, I've had friends give their dogs, which claimed to be vegan, meat from a garbage. Their cats, non-vegan pet food, conventional pet foods, and they just don't know what they're doing to these poor creatures. I mean, if it was their sons or their daughters, would they be feeding meat or meat products to their children? I don't think so. And we have to realize that it's really the animals here. And when we are feeding these things to our children, I know a lot of people, they cook for other people via non-vegan food and they're vegan. They own a restaurant, they claim to be vegan, and the restaurant is not vegan. I mean, I think these people are still not, it seems ridiculous, but I think a lot of these people are still not awakened, but we still need to show...
No, they're not. I mean, being vegan is an awakening of the spirit and of the soul. Once you get that compassion in your heart for the suffering of your fellow beings, your fellow travelers on the planet, then you can't. The only thing you can do is live a vegan lifestyle, and it includes everything. It includes looking at all the labels. It includes the shampoo. It includes everything. It includes everything. Yes.
Oh, I hate to break in. Would somebody post on Facebook where they can purchase these things? Because most people don't know, myself included. I was always led to believe that cats have to have taurine or something. But if you will post this on Facebook so that we can spread the word and let everybody know.
Evolution Diet is a pet food company that's been around for over 25 years. My animals are just thriving on it. They're in beautiful. Yes, but you're hearing of it now, and I had never heard of it either. Actually, I had. My older sister, told me about it years before I became vegan, and I told her, that's preposterous. I can't feed my, I wasn't a vegan. My soul hadn't changed. It hadn't changed. So why would I think of giving my animals a vegan pet food? But as soon as my soul changed, it completely changed. I found Evolution Diet the next day. I found it without the internet. I immediately found it. Immediately.
Okay, there are three companies. First off, I'm going to tell you, there's one called Evolution Diet, which we were talking about, and that is petfoodshop.com. So pet food, all one word, petfoodshop.com, where you can actually buy the food, buy the products right online. Or a lot of pet stores actually have, they carry Evolution Diet. I know in Canada, what's the company? Oh my goodness, I totally forgot. It's a brand name company, but Pet Value carries it. Not all stores, but Pet Value carries it in some of the larger stores.
Found a single store in California that carries Evolution Diet. I'd love to. I wanted to distribute it, but I just couldn't do it. So what I get it right. I just call an 800 number, will have that. I will have Sharon post that on our Facebook page.
Right.
Oh, thank you.
There's two other ones which I like to mention. I don't want to just dismiss all the other vegan companies that I know of. One is called V-Dog, and it's for pooches. And unfortunately, the owner of this company passed away recently of some kind of tragic incident. He was really a wonderful human being for the animals. And it is v-dog.com. And another one is Amy Pet Food, and it has cat for cats and dogs. And it's an Italian company. And it's Amy, A-M-I, petfood.com, and you can check that out as well. Amy, I have found in Toronto, so pretty sure that some stores will carry it. Just contact them, and they'll tell you the locations.
And I am partial to Evolution
Welcome.
Diet because I see my... How my pets are on it, and they're in beautiful condition. And Eric
right.
is a very brilliant the way he put together. It has all the nutrients, taurine, everything that a pet needs. And my dogs don't. My one puppy is almost 8 years old. He's been on it since he was 4 months old. Okay, I'm going to clear the line. So just hold on. I'm going to clear the line. One of them has almost been on it all his life, and the other one's just a year older than he is. And he doesn't have all those, you know, diseases that the dogs have, you know, with the skin and all that stuff. Evolution Diet only because I've been using it, and the proof is in the using. And it's beautiful.
Yeah.
They're in beautiful shape. My pets are all in beautiful shape. They all have, you know, glossy coats, and they're not overweight, and they're in beautiful shape.
Of course.
So,
one other thing I'd like to add in, please, if you is that for people that are on the line or people that are listening to this at any time later on, if you still want some proof that dogs and cats are actually able to thrive on a vegan diet, just check out, I can't remember how to spell her name, but she's a veteran. I'm going to check her up 1 second. She's a veterinarian. And she actually is a veterinarian for dogs and cats. And her name is Dr. I'm Armighty May. And
I know Armighty May very, very well. In fact, she lived two blocks from where my mother lived. So, yes,
right.
Yes, she's a vegan pet. She's a vegan pet food person. I mean, she's
a
vegan vet. She's a vegan
veterinarian,
vet.
Yes.
Yeah,
and,
Armighty.
She
and her mother Dunn are friends of my personal friends of mine. So yeah, I know. In fact, I may have her come.
Can I interject something?
I may have her come aboard if I can get her. I don't know what's happening, but she'll probably be willing to speak to us a little bit on the World Peace Diet Study Group. I'm sure she'll come. She's a friend of. Well, she's wonderful. Yep. Yep. All right. Did somebody want to ask something else before we end this session?
No, this is Robin. I want to comment.
Okay.
It's Robin.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, hi. This man mentioned other companies out there. They're probably very good, but I cannot imagine that anyone is as educated and trained as Eric Weisman is and has the background and the research and pet food nutritionist, so I would put him at the very top of the list. And
thank you for that, Robin. Yeah, I agree with you. I totally agree with you. Yeah,
yep.
Totally. Thank you for that.